Hey everybody, this is Roberto Blake of RobertoBlake.com helping you create something awesome today. So today I'm going to be reviewing the 85mm f1.8 lens from Nikon, and I actually thought this lens was amazing. So I actually rented this lens for a couple of days from Lumoid so I could play with it and decide whether or not I want to commit to buying one in the near future. I'm looking at some lens upgrades here on the channel, both for my own personal photography, but also for some film project stuff that I have coming up. And I really was wondering whether or not this 85mm lens is worth it or not. For me, I think that it really is, but I wanted to give you guys a full review so you can make your own decision about that. This lens is great in low light situations, both for DSLR video and for photography. And there are a couple of reasons why. For one thing, the 85mm focal length is really ideal for shooting portraits, but also for getting candid street photography. So if you're doing video documentary stuff, this could be a really good lens. Even though you don't have the zoom flexibility, that's okay creatively from the perspective of a documentary filmmaker, in my opinion. It really just depends on what you're trying to do. And in low light situations, I think that this has some fantastic capabilities for you, and you can still get some amazing shots at a distance. So I think that the 85mm focal length is really good for that, and I was impressed with the quality of images and video that I was able to get without having to get dead on a subject or in the middle of the action while it's going on. So I really like that. One of the other features of this particular lens from Nikon is it does have both manual auto as well as full manual focus. So that's great. The focusing distance at a minimum is 0.8 meters. This means that the closest you can be to a subject and focus accurately is going to be about maybe 2.2 feet. So this could be good for a lot of reasons, as well as this could be a negative. The good thing about that is that in situations where you're doing portrait photography, working with models, you can create enough distance so that they don't feel, you know, really anxious about the camera, especially if it's somebody new or somebody young. And so there's not that level of intensity. This can allow them to relax better, and you can get some better shots in terms of facial expressions, and it's just gonna feel more natural. So this is great. It's also great for candids when you're working in the real world, working an event, or doing street photography. So that's one thing to really think about with this lens and whether it's for you or not. In terms of things that you're gonna have to be concerned about is this lens is a little weighty, but build quality is somewhere between metal and plastic, so it's solid build quality. I really wouldn't want to get hit in the head with this, but I don't think it's going to do permanent damage if I am. So that's kind of how I'm rating the build quality on this. It does have the silent wave motor, and for me, for the autofocusing, it wasn't that loud. So I do appreciate that. You will too if you're somebody who's doing DSLR video and doing film, or you're shooting at an event. So that's something to consider. The focus ring does go both ways. So that's nice. It does have a minimum aperture of f16. So you will be able to shoot Sunny 16, but that's the extent of it. Its widest aperture in this particular lens, of course, is f1.8. So that's its maximum. So it's between f1.8 and f16. Those are your options in terms of the aperture. This did great no matter what situation I put it in for the most part. And I am really pleased with the results. Whether it was shooting in low light situations, whether it was shooting DSLR video, I had no problems with it. And the focusing on this was actually really fast, and I found it to be pretty accurate as long as I was keeping the minimum focus distance in mind. So again, you have to worry about that minimum focus distance. This is not a macro lens. The bokeh on this was pretty sweet. Creamy is the word that comes to mind. So the quality of the depth of field blur was beautiful, and I love how it came out in my shots, both when doing DSLR video and doing photography. This worked out really well for me, and I'm happy with the results that I got. This does come with a lens hood, and it does go both ways on there, so you can make this a little smaller if you need to. And again, the weight and heft is okay. The build quality is, again, solid. In this case, we've got a filter on here. It's a UV filter from Tiffin that helps protect the lens. And the thing I like about Lumoid is they send that with most of the stuff that you get, so that you have a better chance of not scratching the glass. So I like that. This lens retails at under $500, about 400 bucks. And I think that's a solid price for the quality that you're getting. If you have a 35mm and you were thinking of investing in another prime lens, while there's a lot of versatility in the 50mm, The 85mm is a bigger gap between the two, and you'll get different types of shots from it. So if you're really focused on possibly doing portraits and candid, I would really consider getting this, even though it's twice the price of the 50mm in most cases, I would say that's worthwhile. If you have the 50mm and you don't have a 35, I'd also say that just getting the extra distance out of this, whether you're on a crop body or a full frame, is definitely worthwhile, and it's a good overall investment. In this price range, I really don't think that there's actually a better overall lens to add to your kit. If you spend a few more dollars, sure, you get something in the zoom range from an off-brand for maybe $500 or $600, $700 in the f2.8 range. But if low light is a real concern for you and you want to be able to go up to f1.8, and if you really want to be able to go the distance, if you will, with 85mm, then again, this is a great option for you, and I'm really pleased with what it was able to produce for me. The only negatives that I could say about this lens are the front weight does make it a little awkward, just depending on what your body type is and how you're used to holding a camera, but no more so than any professional glass that you'll be using. In fact, they're a lot heavier. Like when I borrowed my friend's 24-70, that was a monster. That was a lot of ungainly front weight to deal with, and I had to reposition my body accordingly. You'll have less of a hard time with this. So if you're somebody who's a smaller body person, smaller frame person, then this might be a really good lens for you to get used to the idea of using something that's a little heavier than the Nifty 50 or the 85mm or your kit lens. Overall, the image quality that this produces is far superior to the kit lens and superior to the kit zoom lenses like the 50 to 200. So I would say that if you're looking for something that can provide great subject isolation, beautiful bokeh, and can handle low light situations, that the 85mm f1.8 is one of the best lenses you could put in your bag today, and I would highly recommend it. I've also done a video that covers really my top 5 reasons real quick of why I think everybody should have some kind of 85mm lens, so make sure you're also checking that on the channel. Again, I haven't committed to buying this yet, but I probably will in the next few months when I make my final decision on what I'm gonna buy. I'm gonna be reviewing a few more lenses here on the channel for you guys as I make up my decision on what's gonna be in my camera bag this year. But if you wanna try this before you buy it or any other lenses, you can go ahead and rent them from our friends over at Lumoid. There's a link up here in the info card, probably one in the description below as well. Again, they're not sponsoring this video, but I did use them to rent this lens for a few days so that I could share it with you guys and so I could play with it for myself. Anyway, I hope you guys found this video informative. If you still have questions, leave those in the comment section. I'll try and answer as many of them as I can. Like this video if you like it. Don't forget to subscribe. Check out the other awesome content on the channel. As always, you guys, thanks so very much for watching. And don't forget, create something awesome today with whatever lens you have.